Hello YouTube, and hello to my dear subscribers. A new video from Kyla. And today I'm gonna, or at least in this video, I'm gonna talk about four games that are on my list to buy at the end of this month. So basically that's, for me that's next week. I've been looking through some games for the PlayStation, for the Vita and for the PC. And I got a list of four RPG games that are... I don't think they are all Japanese-inspired RPG games, but... two of them are, at least. The first one I'm definitely gonna buy, and that's the most expensive one, is Final Fantasy XII, The Zodiac Age. I didn't know that was a remaster for Final Fantasy XII. And actually, I never played Final Fantasy XII before. And what I'm seeing so far in screenshots, gameplay videos, and something else I'm gonna show later, this is probably a Final Fantasy, probably, that I can maybe enjoy. There are no sentinels in this game. Yeah, here we go again, Final Fantasy XIII. I know some of you really liked Final Fantasy XIII. I didn't like the setting. It's not a Final Fantasy XV. Final Fantasy XIII was too futuristic. Final Fantasy XV is current age, with driving with a car. In Final Fantasy game, it made no sense to me. No. But this game looks like it's back to the original swords and magic age. More the fantasy age that I personally prefer. And I have here a video from Game Cross, which shows some battle gameplay, which looks interesting. This looks like a Final Fantasy that I think I can enjoy. It's I read you can directly control party members if you like. And there are females in your party in this game. So that's a welcome change over 15. I don't know. Now 15 was not my thing either. It's open world, but I didn't like it. I think 13 was better than 15, to my opinion. But the thing that surprised me most was this. Now we get a gambit system, and you can give your party member orders via the gambit system before a battle on what to prioritize or how to handle a battle. It's like if-then statements. So in this preview, the highest is the what's on top is the highest priority. So if an ally has a status KO, use a Phoenix down on that guy or girl. So the further down you go, the less priority there. So reviving people is the highest priority for this person. Then a cure, an ether, a remedy. And the blue are defensive ones. And the red ones are attack. Things you can do to attack. So if there are more than two foes present, use a free raga on one of them. If there's a foe who is weak to ice, use a Blizzara on them. So this is so amazing. So you can really give your party members detailed instructions. And I see there's a picture here as well. Look, this is a totally defensive build. It's all blue. And if none of these if-then statements are true, this guy will use Tundaga. Let's watch one more. So this is amazing. You can really give your party members good instructions. If there's a flying foe, use Soul Eater on them. If there's a foe targeting the character, attack him. So this can really become so much fun. So Final Fantasy XII on the PlayStation 4 is for me a definite buy. I'm gonna try Final Fantasy one more time. And I said that so many times last couple of years. But I'm gonna give it I'm optimistic. I'm optimistic about Final Fantasy XII. So, enough about this. Looks interesting. I'm gonna try it out. And I'll give you a first impressions when I'm starting to play it. Then, there's another game. It's called Children of Zodiacs. So, hey, basically, we got Final Fantasy XII, the Zodiac Age. And we got Children of Zodiacs. This is another game published by Square Enix. But it's developed by a different company. And it's going to be released on the PlayStation 4 and on the PC. Let's just run a trailer in the background. It's not developed by Square Enix. It's developed by Cupboard Utopia. A company I never heard of before. But this looks like an interesting strategy RPG game. With cards and dice. But it's not so bad with the cards that if you don't have a good card. It's not that RNG. Cards and dice are basically to buff your attacks. So it's not... Yeah, you can build your ultimate deck as well. Looks interesting. It's a shame. This game will only be available as digital download. There are physical copies, but they are only for the Kickstarter. The people who helped kickstart this game. So, and it's not expensive. At the moment it's 16 euros on Steam and 18 or 19 euros on the PlayStation 4 digital store. And personally, I would have preferred paying 30 euros for a physical copy of this game. But that's not an option. This is not a game which sells millions of copies. So, digital, I guess, was the only way. But I'm glad they released it. And gonna give it a try. So it's on the PlayStation 4 and on Steam. Pick your choice. Children of Zodiacs. Strategical RPG, Japanese with cards and dice. Could be interesting. Then, let's go to Monsters Den Godfall. A game has been released this week on Steam. I think by Monstrum Games, probably yes. Let's see. Monsters Den Godfall. It's 15 euros. So it's a PC exclusive. All those console guys with their exclusive. This is a PC exclusive. And I don't think many people will care anyway. It's very basic. It's a finished game, so it's not early access. The developers are still making small updates, so that's good. It's not a release. It's developed and published by Monstrum. Yeah, and let's just look the trailer. It's nothing spectacular. It's just a 480p trailer. I'm shutting down the volume. It's some kind of dungeon crawler, but I think it's very basic, but could be interesting. See, the battles are just this isometric view. So not much movement, but for 15 euros, I'm willing to give this game a try and support the developer. Well, it looks basic, but it could be a hidden gem. I'm gonna try it. Yeah, the battles are just like it is just like this. You got a healer and a DPS and a mage. You know the drill. And yeah, so Monsters Den Godfall on Steam looks interesting. It's not my top game of August, but it's one I'm going to give it. I'm going to give it a try. And the fourth and last game is Tower of Time. Let's first go. It's another PC exclusive. Children of Time. Where are you? Here he is. Let's remove the sound. It's a game by Event Horizon, developed and published by them. They're also making small updates. It's an early access game, and it's gonna have 3 or 4 chapters, and the first chapter is complete, and they completed the first chapter and then put the game on early access. So the first chapter is completely as it should be. It's basically finished, and they are now working on the second chapter. And Tower of Time is it's a cross between, to my opinion, I think Pillars of Eternity, that kind of game, and Dungeon Defender. Let's watch the trailer on YouTube. I must say the graphics looks very impressive. The music, I watched the video, the music in this game is very good. The graphics are impressive. The story, what I read so far is from other reviewers, is very well written. And yeah, this part plays like it's Pillars of Eternity, exploring some kind of tower. And I think we'll soon get to the battle system. Yeah, it looks great even. Yeah, we got the attributes, of course. And here's about the battle. The battles in Pillars of Eternity is you encounter an enemy on the map and you gotta fight them. But this game handles it differently. That's basically a bit the tower defense kind of taste. You will enter some kind of battle area, and you'll get a wave of enemies. So that's not the one enemy you encountered on the map. No, it's you go to a battle arena, and on top you see how many enemies you have defeated, 17%. So your party is now fighting these dudes, and after a couple of seconds, I don't know the time interval, but more enemies will spawn. They will just keep spawning and spawning and spawning until all 100% of the enemies are defeated. So you got your party of DPS and your tank. And yeah, it looks great. I don't know if I would like the battle system. Well, the battle system looks okay, because you got all the familiar skills, of course, and fireball and healings and all that good stuff. But I don't know if I like that wave system. But this game, they ask, another 15 euros game. And to my opinion, also this developer deserves some kind. He's also, as you can see, almost daily you'll get an update. It's always a risk with early access games, but I don't have a feeling this will be an abandoned game. And if so, yeah, 15 euros is not much. So I'm gonna support Event Horizon as well with Tower of Time. And those four games are basically the highest on my list for next month. I haven't found, or yeah, I still need Nier. I still want Nier, basically. Why did it stop playing? Oh, it's caching. That's why. I still haven't bought Nier Automata. Which is, I know, it's a shame. I should buy it, but I think Final Fantasy is getting a higher priority this month. So maybe next month. And then I can buy it for a reasonable price with the DLC included. So, yeah. That's the four games, guys. And this live concert of Nier is amazing. Nakada Takashi. You can find the original Nier concert. There's also a Nier Automata concert already, live. But I don't know the music yet of that game, so it doesn't impact me like this. But I'm gonna end the video here, just too much rambling. Thank you for watching. Maybe there's a game in the list that you didn't know about and maybe it looks interesting. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye bye from Garda.